It's rare for an artist, particularly if he's a relatively unknown one, to have the chance of showing his wares in a prime central London location. But now four of them have that chance. Because there are some shops in Soho empty and in these recessionary times waiting for tenants, the organisation Alternative Arts has arranged with the landlords to let the artists use their premises for a month at a time as galleries.
It isn't fun for all these shops to be just empty, and it seems to me a really good idea for artists to be able to exhibit their work. I know a lot of artists who really need gallery space.
Do you encounter much opposition from the landlords?
Oh, not at all. They're very supportive of it. It makes their premises look extremely well.
Because there's no money in it for, well, the artists certainly, but there's no money in it for the landlords either, is there?
Oh, not at all. It's just completely temporary let for the artists to be able to use the space to exhibit their work and sell it directly to the public.
Initially, four artists have taken up temporary residence here. David Harrison, who gets his inspiration, among other things, from painting his poodles, is one.
Oh, I suppose it reaches a much wider audience, which is very good. And also, this is such, you know, it's one of the busiest parts of town, really.
And Liz Davis is one.
It's wonderful because we can talk to the public and we can get their opinion on what we're doing, which is the most important thing.
Reiko Kubo from Japan is another.
It is kind of a great opportunity to do this. It's wonderful.
And Paul Hamlin is the fourth.
I think a tremendous advantage of these galleries, which in a sense is alternative from other galleries, is the fact there's no dealer pressure, there's no pressure, there's no market pressure. And so there is often a gentle pressure, but definitely a pressure from the market through the dealers to the artist to do a particular kind of thing, which you don't get in this situation at all. So it's really, it's exciting, we can do whatever we want.
And next month there'll be four more artists using these alternative galleries. And the work of the present group is being previewed tomorrow and can be seen from Wednesday. Christopher Rainbow for Thames News.